That is right. It is a one-way receiver.
In other words, he gives out the laws and the rules and they must abide by it.
That's right. You're
perfect. You won't want him coming back because, mate, it would be too good. Okay, interesting stuff.
Okay, so Brian Exner in the 68 just came out the gate. That's what we were waiting for. He is there now, so hopefully not too far away. Green flag at the ready, and we go racing. Simon Spitzbach, the Darwinite, is out in front for Streamline Automotive. He's going to do a good job.
We've turned around right into the tyre. The yellow light's been brought on immediately, and he just shoved around the fraction. Fun. And definitely, absolutely good to see all happening out here. All right, let's take a look and see his area. The back end here getting really bunched up in two. Here we go, on the green, we're racing once again. Here we go, Barrett, let's take it away.
Okay, Hayden Jolly this time in the Mrs. Mechanical 59 entry has the lead, though, although it's only slender right now. Here comes Brumfield from the Northern Territory. He slides into the lead aboard the 15. Neville Nitschke is there in the 58, as is Heinrich. They'll battle it out as they come around. Hayden Jolly further back, Spitzbach from the Territory trying to find his way through. As is the well-presented 89 there, and we'll keep an eye on them as they battle down the back chute. Remember, only the top four go through.
Absolutely, and they're pretty clean, spreading out pretty quickly also around this racetrack as we continue. The boy from Northern Territory, Sam Brumfield, leads the way from Bailey Heinrich. They work it well from the 15 to 86. We go to the third spot also down there with Andrew Jordan. They're the guys leading first, second and third as they start to slowly create a bit of a dust bowl. But I tell you now, the guys are working out a lot of entries out there. The racetrack is hanging on.
Neville Nitschke and Simon Spitzbach out there running on the bubble now. They both want fourth position and they're door handle to door handle. It's a long way to come from the Territory to miss out. And also for Neville, it's a long way from Renmark to sit on the sidelines too.
Absolutely.
But fourth right now, that is on. Neither of these two will yield, but looks like Spitzbach at the moment with that position as they come around.
Absolutely. Entry number 68 has collected the tyre, but got himself back onto the racetrack and circling once again. Saved the yellow light, back to the race once again. Barron's back to the leaders down here.
Yeah, that's a big entry there out in front, doing a good job as we watch the Northern Territory and Sam Brumfield doing the good job. Of course, expat South Aussie now living in the Territory, and Heinrich is right there. Look at Bailey, he's trying to find a way through. As is the well-presented entry there. We got a spinner, but they continue to go, and we are still green as they shoot down the back there.
We got another over the far side, and it does bring the yellow light on.
And here, because the Australian title is roughly about a month away.
Yeah, not too far away at all, and as you said, and Bailey Heinrich has squeezed in the second spot at the moment. Let's have a look, then go back, and we get the race underway again on the green light. Here we go, number 15 again, the Northern Territory of Sam Brumfield with Bailey Heinrich as they go through single file to the George Tattnall stand.
Absolutely, Simon Spitzbach lives again in the 43. He's running in fourth position right now. And also out there is the very well-presented car. I think that's the number 98, although not coming up on the transponder right now. As you see the 89 go by, and he is running. Tony Prudhoe has come on in leaps and bounds in the 22. But it will be Sam Brumfield to lead them around. And, of course, Bailey Heinrich is right there. Simon Spitzbach back in fourth. We'll look for a way through.
some good top speed at the end of the rear main straight. They come around, get from turn four to the front main straight. Number 15, of course, Sam Bremen, the Northern Territory. He's been doing such a fine job of keeping his nose ahead lap after lap down here, Paris.
Have a look, Heinrich is now under attack from Neville Nischke in the 58. He has really moved mountains in this race, there is no doubt about that. So keep an eye on Nev as we got a retiree there. I think that is Wayne Forrester's from the Wyala Speedway.
Absolutely, as we go back to first, second, third, bit of a reshuffle maybe happening between the guys down there at the same time as they put the power on down the back main straight this time round. But Sam Brumfield from Northern Territory, he still says, I'm going to show you blokes the short way home. He keeps the power on down the raceway once again, still leading. We go back to engine number 86, 58, and also the fourth man, still all holding together.
Yeah, the 89, the Victorian there in Jordan, he is looking for a way through. Let's see what he can do now. But out in front, still doing a great job and leading well. He's led this one pretty much from go to woe thus far. It is none other than Sammy Brumfield in the 15. And Heinrich now, he's gone upstairs. He's going to try to switch back underneath.
On the low side, back to the high side, down on the low side. He's on his car. He goes around him. He got Sanders between the two of them. We go back to Sam. Sam now, he leads the race. The man, the baby Heinrich. Oh, he's going out wide once again here, Paris. It's all happening.
Something's got to give. Brumfield back in front. Look at that, Nischke. He is the race of his life on the outside. Oh, we've gone yellow.
We've got a good step back behind them.
Are still a shot.
So we've got Brumfield, Greg, of course, Prideaux, and Cody Heinrich. They're the four now.
Well, the 89 of Andrew Jordan.
He's in third spot. There he is down there. All right, we're back to it again, ladies and gentlemen. Let's take a look at these guys now. Two laps on that race board. Let's see who's going to take it out. First and third's going to change straight away here again, Paris.
Oh, absolutely. Now Jordan goes back to the bubble. He is in fourth position. He can be passed and knocked out of this after such a great drive all the way from Victoria. Have a look at them now. They are three wide as they throw it in towards the Georgetown stand. Look at that. Nobody wants to give an inch right now. And out in front, it is Neville Nischke.
And 15's losing pace. He's been going slower around the racetrack. I can tell you now, that would have been Sam Brumfield of memory.
Yeah.
But he's definitely lost pace. He's gone from first back to what? Fifth spot. He'll be peaking. We go back to Henry number 58 at the moment. Working it well out there that racetrack. I tell you what, there's only one lap to go. In fact, no, the chicken flag is out there. There it is.
Yeah. All over Red Rover, Neville Nischke in the 58. The president of the Renmark Speedway Club gets the win.
Well, I'll tell you what a race. And I've got my eyes watched all glued down on that racetrack and didn't see the chicken flag. But, man, there's a few quick changes.
This interview done as quickly as we can as the junior street stocks go back into the pits after that B main. As Nev just gets the headwear off. Nev fairly out of the pack. And, two laps to go, you got the win.
Yeah, it was good around the outside, so we just went for it.
And a bit of push and shove through there, but as you said, you got through.
Oh, yeah, no, I did, yep. I'm bugging.
All right, we'll let Nev get back to the pit. And the 58, the Renmark racer, the winner for the B main, and he'll transfer.